Ephesians chapter 6 verse 1. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with thee and thou mayest live long on the earth. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Deuteronomy chapter 5 verse 16. Honor thy father and thy mother, as the Lord thy God hath commanded thee, that thy days may be prolonged, and that it may go well with thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Exodus 20:12. Honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Last first morning, we had a brief meditation on this passage, that it shall go well with thee, that it is right in the sight of God, that your days may be prolonged, the land the Lord has given thee. This is a commandment with God's promise. There are three blessings, very specific. Number one, it is pleasing to the Lord. It is right with the Lord. In the sight of God, it is right. It is approved by God. His delight shall be upon you. When you do the thing that is right with the Lord, His delight shall be upon you. Blessing number one. Blessing number two, in the land the Lord has given you, everything will go well with thee. In the job the Lord has given you. Maybe after marriage, the family the Lord has sent to you. In a ministry. Everything, in every situation, it shall be well with thee. It shall be well with thee. It's a spiritual thing. You might have got a job, maybe in a corporate sector, or you may be a teacher, you're working in an IT firm or an MNC, or you're doing business, the things are going well with thee. The secret in the spiritual world, you are honoring your father, your mother. You are honoring your father, your mother. Things are going well with thee in the land the Lord has given you, the job the Lord has given you. It's a spiritual principle. It's a spiritual principle. And blessing number three, your days will be prolonged on the earth and in the life to come. Forever and ever you shall be blessed. So when the Bible says very specifically, honor your parents, it is not just father and mother. When we read the whole Bible, when you take Bible in all its totality, the Bible says treat elderly men as your father, elderly women, widows as your mother. In Timothy the Bible says, this is paying back to what your parents have done to you. Take care of your parents and grandparents. Parents and grandparents. In 1 Timothy 5:4. So it's not just biological father and mother. Fathers-in-law, mothers-in-law, both men and women. It is not necessary that only the daughter-in-law should take care of the father-in-law and mother-in-law. Son-in-law must take care of the father-in-law and the mother-in-law. They are his parents. He has to take care of them. He has to show respect to them. She has to show respect to his her parents-in-law. And it doesn't stop with that. Grandparents. We should teach our children. This is how we can pay back to what they have done to us. And this is the religion. If we don't provide for them, we are worse than infidels. And I love to draw your attention to Leviticus chapter 19 verse 32. Leviticus 19 verse 32. How to honor the elderly people. The Bible says, thou shalt rise up before the hoary head, that is gray head. Thou shalt rise up before the hoary head and honor the face of the old man and fear thy God. I am the Lord. I am Yahweh. How to show that you fear the Lord? When you see an elderly person, he is a good man or a bad man, educated or not educated. When you see a gray hair, an elderly person, the Bible says, rise up, and honor the face of that old man. Honor the face of that old man. That is reverence to God. That's religion. The Bible that teaches be baptized, the Bible that teaches believe in baptism, the same Bible teaches rise up when you see an old man. Can you say that I will obey the Lord in baptism? That's religion. And when I see an old man, I'll just sit having my legs crossed. That's not a religion. Is it not in our Bible? So when you don't know to respect an old man, you are breaking the law of God. You don't have the fear of God. You don't have the fear of God. If you have the fear of God, you will know how to show respect to an old man. It is not just said father or mother. It is not said father-in-law or mother-in-law. It is not said just grandparents. Honor the face of the old man and fear thy God and show reverence to your God. I am Yahweh. I am Yahweh. I am Yahweh. Very emphatically the Lord says. I always, even a few days back, I was talking to somebody. Christianity failed in many areas, and one of those areas, we give more importance to doctrine and we don't give that importance to character. I strongly believe Christianity is character. Following Christ are called Christians. If Christianity cannot make our character different from the character of ordinary people, what is the use of being a Christian? Somebody cannot honor his parents. He cannot honor his old father. He cannot honor his mother in her old age, because he has taken baptism, because he is carrying a Bible, going out doing ministry. You think that the heaven will receive him? Then what will happen to these commandments? My dear brother, my dear sister, doctrines are very, very important. But a character without doctrine is absolute zero. Christianity is very fascinating, especially in the 18th, 19th centuries. The fascination of Christianity was the uncomparable character Christians were showing. My dear brother, my dear sister, many great men like Mahatma Gandhi, Vivekananda, they all got a lot of praise for Christ. It is not just because they studied thoroughly the life of Christ. In the 18th, 19th century, a part of Christians were able to show that Christian character, that love, that forbearance, that respect to the elders. My dear brother, my dear sister, but today Christianity, what's the picture that we present to the world? If there is an elderly person in your family, you are blessed. You have got an opportunity to obey the commandment of God. Any elderly person, maybe a brother, a sister. I got brother, I got sisters. I'm the youngest in my family, they all are elder to me. With all humility, very candidly I can say, by the grace of God, I can preach on this sermon. I know how I respect my brothers, my brother and my sisters. My dear brother, my dear sister, my brother is about 80 years elder to me. If he says something to me, even today, my 62, I cannot do against what my brother says. I respect him. Maybe I don't respect him to the extent that I should respect him, but I respect him. I love to respect him. It's not that I respect him, we respect him. It's not that we respect him, we are very proud to say our children respect him. They respect the elders in our family. Our children respect my brother, sister's brother, our sisters. Teach your children. Don't stop with appa amma, grandparents, parents-in-law. Any senior brother, sister, they've got a hoary head. I'm not saying whether they are good or bad. My dear brother, my dear sister, three blessings. Blessing number one, it is approved in the sight of God. God is delighted over that. Blessing number two, your days will be prolonged on the earth. Blessing number three, in the place the Lord has kept you, everything will be well with thee. Everything shall be well with thee. And when I say children, I'm not just talking about the kids. Every one of us is a child to our parents. The Bible says, when you don't respect your parents, when you don't honor your parents, he or she should be stoned to death. It's a curse. It's a curse. Even in a lighter sense, don't tell your parents, don't tell your father, Daddy, be quiet. Daddy, don't say. Daddy, don't talk like that. Mommy, you don't know. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, curse will be lying at your doorstep. You may not know immediately. It may not be well with your studies. It may not be well in your future. It may not be well with you in the family you go. You will have problems everywhere, but you may not know the reason why. You studied very well. Why could not you shine well in the exam? You go to your job. You are unable to do well in the job. You may not know exactly what was the problem. It may not be well with you in the land the Lord has given you. Maybe if you could turn back and say, somewhere you hurt the elders. He said, Daddy, be quiet. Mommy, shut up, mommy. Mommy, you don't know anything. No, these things should be totally away from the Carmelites. My dear brother, my dear sister, for the glory of the Lord, for your blessings, we present this. We have to honor our parents in five different areas. I don't want to show you a bombard with Bible verses. This morning just I'm sharing this thought with you, and I do believe it shall be well with you in the land the Lord has kept you. Number one, take care of them physically. Take care of them physically. It is their second childhood. Their sight has become weak. They could not hear properly. One more time, they are losing their motor skill. They are unable to hold things properly. Physically, they have become weak. Their bones have become weak. Their digestive system is affected. They may not have control over their internal organs. They may not be able to control their internal organs. At times, they may not know what they are doing. They may wet the bed. They may drop a cup. They may soil the floor. What we all have done when we are children. What we all have done when we were children. Many times we have dropped cups. As babes, we might have wet our bed. We soiled our bed. Our parents were able to put up with us. Now a time has come. As it is said in 1 Timothy 5:16, for repay for what they have done to you. For what they have done to you. Now you are getting an opportunity to show or to pay back what you have received from them. How many sleepless nights you had? How many sleepless nights you had? The Lord has blessed a couple with a child. Last week we visited them. That sister was saying, I could not even sleep for 1 hour. The child gets up, cries, I could not even sleep for 1 hour. We jokingly said, this is how your mother have brought you up. Then why can't we curse the sleepless nights because of our aged parents? Physically, they need our help. This is a reality. when I say physically take care of them, make them feel, in every second, make them feel that they are normal. Make them feel walk. Make them feel move about. Don't say, you are an old man, just sit here. No, they didn't do that. They made us walk. They were very happy to see that we walk. When we walk, we will fall. They lifted us up. So physically, in what are the ways that you should help them so that they could be normal, do it. It is a God-given opportunity to bless you. It is a God-given opportunity to bless you. So that you are able to repay what you have received. So when I say take care of them, first, they need our physical assistance. Suppose they are unable to walk properly, put a hand, take them, walk with them, and walk them, make them walk. Be proud in that. Hey, be quiet, don't come there. They're going for a wedding. They're going to the church. That elderly person, help them walk. Maybe push them in the wheelchair. Were they not pushing us in a pram? Push them in a wheelchair. Be proud about it. Be happy about it. They dirty their place. That is how God wants them to be, so that we can help them. So that God can bless us. It's a chain. It's a chain that brings a balance. If they cannot dirty the bed, if they cannot dirty the break the cup, you may not have an opportunity to show your love. It may sound a little cruel. For me to show the love, should he suffer? But this is how the cycle is to be. Your father, your mother, they don't break a chinaware. They don't soil the bed. They don't dirty the table. Even when they are hale and healthy, they passed away. They died. Young man, young woman, you missed a glorious opportunity to pay back what you received. The rest of the days you will be in debts. The rest of the days you are in a situation where you cannot help somebody who needs a help. It's a very painful thing for me to pay back what I received. Should they suffer? No, they need not suffer. But let me see that they are physically looked after. Maybe her mother would have fed our sister for a few months, maybe for a year. But our sister had a golden opportunity to feed her mother-in-law, literally to feed her mother-in-law for 3.5 years. To feed her mother-in-law when my mother was totally down with a stroke. She was not left to her own mercy. We had the opportunity to feed into her mouth. My dear brother, my dear sister, physically, what all the ways that you have to help them and find a joy in it. As I said earlier, take it as an opportunity God has given you to help them. Physically. They need a physical assistance. They need a physical assistance. You need not just throw them to the room and say, "Inga kada, niyangalla nadakkara, niyangalla pora." No, they want to go. You have to be their legs. You have to be their hands. You have to be their eyes. You have to be their ears. They are short of hearing. Speak a little louder. Speak a little louder. They need your assistance till the end. Make them feel physically they are fit to live on this earth. It is God's plan. God could have kept old people strong enough till the end. If God has kept old people strong enough till the end, then you and I may not have an opportunity to help them, so that cycle will not be complete. In His wisdom, there is a physical weakness for the old people. They lose their teeth. Make a special food for them. When you are without teeth, they were doing it. When we are without teeth, they are doing it. Give them the food that could suit their digestive system. When you are a babe, they were giving you food that could suit you. They didn't say, no, no, I cannot cook twice. I cannot cook one for the child, one for me. What I cook, you let the child eat. No, they didn't say that. They didn't say that. Now today they need a different food. Your brother needs a different food. Your sister needs a different food. In their hoary head, they need a different food. Why can't you have the joy of giving them a different food? When you are a child, they didn't hesitate to make another food. They didn't tell you, eat the same food. If you want to eat, eat, otherwise don't go. No. They wanted to see the food that could suit the child. Then it's your responsibility to see what food that would suit that elderly person. My dear brother, my dear sister, they are not a burden. They are a blessing. It's all your perception. It's all your perception. We had old people in our house. We never thought my mother was a burden to us. We never thought our father was a burden to us. My dear brother, my dear sister, though we didn't feel his presence much, when my father died, we felt his absence much. Even when that old man died, our ministry was affected. We never thought about it earlier. Children will come from the school. Sister would give them some food, some tiffin, coffee. They just take the vehicle and say, Daddy, we'll go. We go for house visitations. We go for prayer meetings. We never thought that who is taking care of these children. We never thought that we've got an old man in the house, a blessing to take care of the children. We never thought about it. We just left home. We went for ministry. One day our father died. The funeral was over. The next day, we couldn't go out for ministry. Because that 89-year-old man was not there. We didn't know where to leave the children. Sister could not make regular house visitations. Though we didn't feel his presence much, in every area his absence was felt. Suddenly I thought, there's nobody above me. There's no pastor, there's no father. I felt that, wow, what a situation it is, there's nobody above me. It was not a joy for me. That was a burden for me. My dear brother, my dear sister, in every area physically you have to take care of them. And it's a joy in taking care of them physically. And area number two, the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, honor the Lord with all your substance and with the first fruits of your increase. Likewise, how to honor our parents financially? financially. Support them financially. This message may be different from what you generally listen to, but this is for your own blessing. As long as they can spend money, let them have the feel of handling cash. It is not that I give you food, eat, don't take money in your hands. Probably at a time where they cannot handle cash is a different thing. Why do they need cash? Maybe for a grandchild. They want to buy a gift. They want to buy a chocolate. They want to have some freedom to spend. One boy is earning very well, sending some money and pestering them, what did you do with that money? What did you do with that money? One day I called him and said, give some money to your mother. Give some money to your mother. What you want to save, you save. But the money that you give to your mother, don't ask for accounts. She is hesitant to say, I have spent for my daughter, I spent for our grandchildren. He may not say anything, but she is hesitant to say that. So she wants to hide it. Let her have some money. What that you are going to lose? A few hundreds. What will she do with that money? Maybe when the daughter comes, she may give some 50 rupees. For your own child, she may love to buy a dress and give to the grandchild. Let them handle money as long as they can handle money. As long as they can handle money. This is very, very important to honor elderly people. All along they spent money. In some houses, the elderly people are very careful. Till their death, they will keep the they will be the finance controller in their family. All children will revolve around them for money, and at times they will also pray when this old man or the old woman will die so that we can take the keys in our hands. They will pray for that old man, old woman to die. I don't say that type of a situation. They are very careful. They only give 50 paisa even to their sons, daughters. And they all will go and stand before their father with their folded hands. I'm not talking about that type of a situation. Your father has spent a lot for you. What we are today, it's because of our parents. Or maybe because of God's grace through them. But show that they will have some finance in their hands. They will waste. They let them waste. What all after all they are going to do? Maybe they give for offerings. They may give to some other ministry. Or they may, to the maximum, they may buy something what they want and eat. Let them have a free hand in finance. I love to underline this fact, as long as they can handle money. My dear brother, my dear sister, because the Bible says, honor the Lord with your substance, with all the first fruits of your increase. Go and give, honor your mother with your substance. They'd be very happy. It's not that they want it. It's not that they need it. It is how you can honor them. How you can honor them? My dear brother, my dear sister, this is very, very important. We have to support them physically, financially. When I say physically, one more thing, give them good food. The other day, I phoned one auto man. The auto man has got some hello tune. That hello tune, there was a dialogue, maybe a cine dialogue or something. The dialogue goes like this. When your mother is hungry, if you eat something, what you eat is not food, it should be called something else. When your mother is hungry, eat something. What you eat is not called food, it should be called something else. See, we are living in a different type of situation. Say, for example, when I was teaching, even before my marriage, maybe I was at the time 24, 25, when an elderly person, a great intellectual giant, a retired principal, he asked me, say, Mr. Simon, you got an answer for every question. I ask a question, can you give me an answer? I said, yes, Mr. Mani. His name was Mani. So Mr. Mani asked me, can you tell me why the homes for the aged are increasing? Why are the homes for the aged increasing? Immediately he said, because crutches are increasing. He laughed. Parents think it's a viable thing to earn for the child, to look after the child. We need more money. So they went and put the child into the crutch so that they can go to work and earn money. So the child learns that formula. When it grows old, the best way to look after the parents, send them to a home for the aged so that they can pay money for that. Now that has become a type of a social viability. That has become a social viability. I don't say whether that's a crush is right or wrong. I don't say home for the aged is right or wrong. But certainly home for the aged is a very good alternative than being in the house in many situations. Mine is take care of them. Take care of them. Physically, financially. Physically, financially. My dear brother, my dear sister, it's a joy to take care of them. And area number three, how you can take care of the aged people, the old people. Take care of them materially. Take care of the material. When you are a child, when we were children, how much they took pains to buy new dress for us, to buy good dress for us, costly dress for us. We are just in the house only, toddlers, crawling. But they wanted to buy the best for us. They were not saying, this torn and tattered one you just wear in the house. You are only in the house. No, they are proud to see that we wear the best dress. When our parents become old, don't allow them to wear something that is torn and tattered. Give them the best. Encourage them to dress in the best way. I know one elderly gentleman, he was in his late 90s. I had never seen him coming out without wearing his necktie in his 90s. He became pretty old, so his children, his grandchildren, helped grandpa every morning, even in the house. They'll help him to put on that tie. They helped him to put on that tie. I have never seen the elderly man. In his 90s he passed away. I have never seen him once without a necktie. Don't say it is not necessary. Be quiet, lie down. That lungi is enough. That house coat is enough. Where are you going? Just be in the house. My dear brother, my dear sister, buy them good dress for their birthdays. Buy them good dress for their special occasions. Help them dress smartly. Help them dress clean dress. And what all the other material things they would require in that age? Give them a comfortable chair. If they need a wheelchair, provide them a wheelchair. My dear brother, my dear sister, when our mother had the stroke, the first thing that, because we learned somewhere, read somewhere, and I remember my father has said that, we set a small aquarium in our house by the side of her cot. She is lying down. Let her see the fish moving around. Let her see the fish moving around. What we can do on that day, for that we didn't require a lot of money. We require a lot of mind. We don't require a lot of money for that. We require a lot of mind for that. My dear brother, my dear sister, what all the material things they may require a hearing aid. Chala pora kalathil nee inmai kaatta enna panna pora. Buy them a hearing aid. They love to have a small tape recorder. Provide them. Let them hear Bible verses. Let them hear some songs. Let them break it. Have we not broken so many things in our life? So when we take care of the old people, physically, financially, materially. Dr. Billy Graham was to attend a small gathering. He agreed that assignment. And his children and grandchildren compelled him that he should have a new pair of suit. He said, why do you want to waste money on this new pair of suit? I just wear one suit. They said, no, you must wear a new pair of suit. So they bought Dr. Billy Graham a new pair of suit. And he said, this suit may be used for two occasions. One is to preach in this meeting, to address this gathering, and another occasion maybe for my funeral. Wearing that suit, he said beautifully, Einstein, the greatest scientist, the man of the millennium, when he was traveling in the bus, in his old age, he lost his ticket. The ticket examiner came and asked for the ticket. Einstein was searching all his pockets here and there, his bags and baggages, he could not find the ticket. So the ticket examiner said, sir, we all know very well, we know that you would have bought your ticket, don't worry, because he is the greatest scientist. Said, don't worry, we know that you have got the ticket. Take it easy. He moved on. After checking other passengers when he was coming back in the aisle, he was able to see that Einstein was off his seat and searching for the ticket under the seats. He was searching for the ticket under the seats. So again the examiner said, sir, we all know you very well. Don't worry about the ticket. We know that you have bought the ticket. Einstein said, that's not the problem. I need the ticket. That's not the problem. I need the ticket. Why do you need the ticket? Einstein said, I don't know where I am going. I don't know where I am going. I should see the ticket where I am going. I don't know where I am going. So Dr. Billy Graham said, the greatest difference between Einstein and I, Einstein didn't know where he was going. I know where I'll be going. This suit can be used for my funeral. This suit can be used for my funeral. My dear brother, my dear sister, buy them a good suit. Buy them a good sari. What they are going to do with that suit? Don't ask that question. Take care of them materially. Another area is very, very important. Take care of them emotionally. They also got a lot of emotions. And it's only the grace of God we can achieve it. My dear brother, my dear sister, even when our own daughter is harsh with our grandchildren, we are unable to bear it. I mean, that's our emotion. Even a shouting, we are unable to take it up. Why she should shout like this on those small little ones? But the parents, the mother, she knows how to set right the children. So we also know that we should not provoke our children. There is a lot of emotional crisscross. My dear brother, my dear sister, I remember when I was chastising my son, our son, our father was unable to take it up. Our father was unable to take it up. But now I realize that's how the Lord has kept our emotions. Don't tell your daddy, daddy, I know how to bring up my children. Daddy, be, don't interfere. Don't interfere. No. The Bible says, listen to your father and mother. Take up their instructions. Don't make them sit in the house as a burden. Somebody who is not numbered. Don't be numb to their feelings. Till the end, they got an emotion, they got a heart, they got feelings. By the grace of God, clinging unto the grace of God, try to satisfy their emotions. This is a responsibility of everybody, grandchildren, sons-in-law, daughters-in-law, anybody. Don't make their heart break. Don't make their heart break because of your situations, because you're married, because of your husband, because of your wife, because you want to take care of your life, because of your children. Don't allow those gray hair to go to their grave in sorrow. It will not be well with you. It may be very difficult, it may be challenging. But I want you to take up the challenge. I want you to rise up to that occasion. Make them happy till the end. Our mother could not talk. She can only make some gestures, some noise. She could sing some tunes, words illegible. You know what my mother was singing till the end? In all her memories, we sing that song in Tamil. Enna en anandam, enna en anandam sollakoodathu. Till her death she was singing that. Enna en anandam sollakoodathu. She was happy. In the last few seconds when my mother and father was reeling in that pain, just for a few seconds, Only those are the few seconds that we could not relieve him from that pain. Till this day my heart condemns me for that. When he had that heart attack for a few minutes, we know we couldn't do anything. But till today my heart condemns me for that. He became silent after a few seconds. See that they don't feel pain in their lives. Satisfy them emotionally. We may have to lose things for that. We may have to lose our patience. We may have to grow in grace. But it's very, very essential. There was an old man. He was suffering from the old age disease. He was losing his motor skill. His son, daughter-in-law and a grandson. They all sit together to eat. He'll take the porridge to his mouth. He will drop it. It will soil the beautiful draper of the table. At times the china bowl was broken. At times that porridge will be spilled on the carpet, which is very difficult to remove. He will make that scene very... The daughter-in-law was angry. The blessed son could understand his beloved wife and the costly carpet and the table draper. A man of understanding. So the best alternative they could make, they made that old man sit in a corner. No more. A china bowl, he would break it. An aluminium bowl, he would sit, there is no other alternative. He would sit in that corner. When his son, daughter-in-law, grandchild, they all sit together and have their grace, pray, they eat their meal. This old man sitting in a corner, he will be drinking his porridge. Days were passing by. God in his mercies relieved him from this agony. The family is also relieved. There's no old man in that family to soil that beautiful draper of the table. There is no man in that old man in that family to break the chinaware. There's no old man in the family to make that beautiful Belgium carpet nasty. God relieved that family. One day, this mother was setting up the small playpen of this boy and she noticed that aluminium bowl what the father-in-law was using within the cherished belongings of this little boy. She was a little annoyed. She just threw it away. And said, "Sonny, why do you want to keep this dirty one also here?" This boy cried, "Mommy, Mommy, don't throw it away. Don't throw it away. I need it." "Why do you need it?" "Mommy, one day you become old. I need this bowl. One day you will become old. I need this Baba. What you sow, you reap. You sow love, you reap love. You sow hatred, you reap hatred. You show tolerance, you reap tolerance. You show impatience, you sow impatience, you reap impatience. You sow one seed, you will reap 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold. You sow one seed, you will reap 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold. You show the love of seed of one love seed, you will get 30 love seeds. You sow one love seed, you will reap 60 love seeds, a sheaf of love. What you sow, you reap. Take care of them physically, financially, materially, emotionally, and socially. Socially. Take them out. Be proud in being with them. Take them to your party. Take them to your social function, to your wedding. They may be blind. They may be lame. Have a joy in that. Have a joy in that. Show that you are a Christian. As long as they desire, have a social acceptance. My dear brother, my dear sister, let the world see that you honor old people. You respect old people. It's not a shame for you. I tell you, it's a crown of glory for you. Be proud of your parents. We are what we are today, but by our parents. Not but by our parents. We are what today, only because our parents. I might have said this earlier, but I don't mind saying this again. One man, in his wickedness, he left his wife and son. He went away, eloped with another woman. His wife, she labored much, carried bricks, carried sand, worked in the fields, housemaid in many houses, brought up her son. He studied very well. He respected his mother. And he became a government servant. Very quickly he became a gazetted officer. His mother had the golden opportunity to see how this boy was coming up in life, and she died. Years were passing by. That father was left by that his mistress. He was very old. There's nobody to take care of him. He was coming and lying in front of this boy's house. He didn't want to take care of his father. He remembered how much he tortured his mother. He remembered the painful days of his mother. He remembered how the father first took his mother and him to their own mercies and left with another woman. He didn't want to take care of that father. This case went to a magistrate. Magistrates called this man to his house. He was also a man of respect, a gazetted officer. He was talking to that gazetted officer. He said, it's our duty to take care of our father, however wicked they are. My brother was in that house on that day. That magistrate was our family friend. So he was trying to explain to that man, okay, just as he give food to some dogs, why can't he give food to this man? He'll be living for some more time, let him eat. The law, you are blessed, you have got a good salary, you got a good house. Let him be in a corner of a house, let him eat something. This man was not agreeing. This man was not agreeing. He said, "No, I remember what our parents, what our father has done to us. I cannot show mercy to him. I can show mercy to a dog, not to this man." He asked, "What's your name?" He said, "Why, what's your name?" "S. Mani," or something, "S. Subramani," or something. "S. Mani." "What? S. Mani." The magistrate got annoyed. "What is that S? All along in your certificate you are holding that S, the initial of your father. If you don't have this initial of your father, your mother's character will be questionable and you would have become an illegitimate child who didn't know his father." This man got shocked. "You are able to have a reputation in the life. Your mother is able to have a reputation in the society because of that one letter, yes. For bearing that one letter, yes, all these years, take care of that man for the rest of your life or I'll book you. For having that one letter, yes, that was holding the reputation of your mother and you for all these years. Otherwise, your mother's character was questionable and you are an illegitimate child not knowing who the father was. Only that letter was keeping a reputation for you. Feed your father for that sake. None of us have fallen from heaven. We are today what we are but because of our parents. Show that love, show that respect. Your husband is not somebody just as a crane was flying overhead and dropped in your house. Your husband is the gift your parents-in-law have given in your hands. Your wife so. Show love and respect to them. It's a great blessing. I'm saying either way, it's not only a daughter-in-law, a son-in-law, a daughter-in-law. Have a joy in that. Let them have a good social standing. I remember one instant with that, I want to conclude. They are basically from the South Tamil Nadu, Tirunelveli in a village. This boy studied well. He got a very big job in the management capacity in a very big company in Bombay. His wife also had an equal standing in the society. But they respected that old father. And always is asking, "Come daddy for some time to Bombay, come daddy for some time to Bombay." This old man from the village, he said, "What, I don't know Hindi, I cannot go around, what is the use of I am coming?" He said, "No daddy, just come and spend some time with us." So this old man from South Tamil Nadu, from a village, he went to Bombay. So this man made arrangement with a coffee shop in the opposite house. Whatever my father would come and ask, whatever he would ask, you give him. Coffee, tea or any snacks, whatever he asks, give him. Don't say no, don't ask any money, I will pay for that. So whenever this man would want to buy something, he would go to the tuck shop, he would buy. A week or so passed by, the son and the daughter-in-law, they wanted to take him to one of the big star hotels in Bombay, which something he had never seen, this man had never seen in his life. So he didn't know how to manage with the buffet and all, but the son and the daughter-in-law were encouraging. This man was wearing a dhoti. The son was very happy. It's our attire. He was just wearing a dhoti and a shirt. At the end, just as with a keepsake, they were giving a lot of nice groundnuts. Literally happened. This man from the village, he loved those groundnuts. So he took his dhoti, he folded it and tied it. That's how they generally do in the village. They took the dhoti, folded it and tied it. Took all these groundnuts, put it into that folding. What he would have done it in his village. The son was noticing that, the daughter-in-law was noticing that, they didn't mind it. He put everything in the dhoti, he was coming. and he was stripped by the carpet, and that folding came off, and all these groundnuts spilled on the ground. The waiter passing by saw that and he giggled, laughed. The son, he was a very big manager in a big company, he gave a stern look at that waiter. Son and the daughter-in-law bent down. They picked up all those groundnuts without leaving one single piece. They gave to their father. His friend was also, a friend also accompanied them, this manager's friend. Next day, the friend asked him, when your father was taking that groundnut and hiding it in his dhoti, when it was spilled over, were you not embarrassed? Everybody is looking at you. You are a regular visitor to this hotel. He said, why should I feel embarrassed? I have paid for that groundnuts also. He is my father. I don't remember a day. My father was embarrassed of me. Always he has been proud of me. Always he has been proud of me. Why should I be embarrassed of my father? I am proud of my father. I am what I am today, but not by my father. But not by my father. I am what I am today is only because of my father. Why should I be embarrassed of him? My dear brother, my dear sister, for everything to be well with you, for your life to be approved in the sight of God, in this world and for the world to come, for you to live forever and ever, honor, respect old people. Leviticus 19:32, don't forget. In all ways possible, not only these five principles, in all ways possible, try to honor them. Leviticus 19:32. When you see an old man, arise up, honor the face of that old man, and fear God, for I am Yahweh. Shall we close our eyes? Ask God for this grace to show reverence to old people, to have a joy in taking care of them. It may be difficult, it may be challenging, but that blessing will take you a long way. Take this message to somebody you know. Share this message with your friends and relatives, your colleagues, your brothers and sisters, that everything would be well with them. That everything would be well with them. Dear Father God, I thank you, I praise you, I worship you for this wonderful morning. I have shared with your people what you have burdened me, O Lord. That everything could be well with them in the place where you are kept, O Lord. Send them back home with your heavenly benedictions. In Jesus' name. Amen.